Hey guys, Elven Archer here, and in today's video I want to show you how to make this pretty sweet bat quiver for about $10. Stick with me. So I've really been in love with this quiver design for a while because it has a third strap. This means that it's both more comfortable, because it doesn't need to be very tight, and it also doesn't have all of the classic problems that you have with a single strap quiver. It doesn't slide around, and the arrows don't fall backwards as you're reaching for them. And today, I want to show you how to make this for about $10 or $15. Let's get on over to my badly lit workshop. Ah, what a mess. Let's move all of this stuff onto the other bench so it looks like I keep a clean workshop. Look how clean that workbench is, you know, as long as you ignore, look at that spot. That spot right there on that workbench, that is a clean workbench. Let's start on the tube part of the quiver. And you can get as complicated with this as you want. For this particular one, I used some of this. This is PVC air duct pipe. It's really thin-walled pipe, which means that the end product is really light. Now, I don't want to make this video super long, so, you know, heat up one side, flatten it slightly so it sits against your back. You can open up the end so it's easier to get the arrows out, and then either put a cap or close up this end. You can do all of that or none of it. The one thing I would suggest doing is opening up the top as much as you can so it's easier to put your arrows in. So this is what we're going to be making. It's not super complicated, so I'm going to just show you all of the pieces that you need. By the magic of editing, already made that joke. So here's everything that you're going to need. Roughly your arm span worth of 2-inch wide nylon webbing. Get the really smooth seatbelt kind of material because that's going to stop it from rubbing on your shoulder so much. Two of these little Velcro straps. Now the original used 5 of these webbing tensioners. I'm just gonna use 4 for this one. 1 2-inch buckle, a 1-inch buckle, a 2.5-foot section of 1-inch strap, and a 6-inch section of 1-inch strap. And also one of these. I don't know what they're called, I'll put it up on screen, but they're just about the most useful little clip ever. So, let's start with just our webbing and the 2-inch buckle. Now the original design had both ends of the strap running through the buckle and then through a tensioner. Instead of doing that, I'm going to simplify it by just attaching the strap to the male side of the buckle. And I'm going to do that with a couple of grommets. And after looking at this, I'm realizing that there's no way to make the strap lie flat. So I'm going to take probably just a handsaw and remove some of this plastic. Yeah, that's much better. How do I make sure that my holes line up? I know.
Just the on button. Yeah,
am I stupid? Ah, it's that one. Wait, it's not threaded. Hold on. We have to back up. Get around the other thing. Then do we do this? I'm gonna use a pedal. Okay, so my skill in sewing aside, that'll do fine. Put that here, and then I need to get my hammer. So the next piece that needs to go on is the female side to the smaller buckle. And for that, we're going to use our 1-foot section of 1-inch strap and one of our tensioners. So we're just going to take that tensioner, put it on, and now we're going to take it back off and put it on the right way. So we're going to make a little bit more space and then feed one end through, pull the other end under. Do you see we now have these two tails through the top part of the buckle, around and through the bottom part of the buckle. Push those through and cinch it down. You would almost think that I hadn't put this together multiple times before this video. So if you're right-handed and looking up towards the large buckle, the small buckle should go off to the right. But because I'm left-handed, that small buckle needs to go the other way. We now put on the next two tensioners. So we're gonna put the first Velcro strap just right through like so. So same deal as before. If you're right-handed, have this strap going off to the right. If you're left-handed, have it go off to the left. We're gonna put this under and through. Then we're gonna take our little clip over both pieces and then through it a second time. So we put a loop up through. Clip those shut. This buckle can be put on the way it's meant to be put on because we actually are going to need to tighten and loosen this one. And also this side gets our second, forgot about that, gets our second strap. Getting into the final steps, put our last tensioner on, put our buckle on, feed the strap through the buckle, through the tensioner. And now we just have to spend a few minutes adjusting everything to make sure it's comfortable. So we'll lay this out, we'll lay the quiver on top, realize that I put both of the Velcro straps on backwards, fix the Velcro straps, now we lay the quiver over, strap it on, and first thing I'm gonna do is tighten the main strap until it's comfortably tight. That's pretty good. Tighten that, strap it down. There's definitely gonna be a break-in period on this because you're gonna have to find exactly where the straps should sit so that they're the most comfortable, but that's it, that's all you gotta do. You got a super functional quiver, doesn't fly around, and let me show you something pretty else. That's what I was about to say. Let me show you something else that's pretty cool about it. I just split my target in half. So I hope you enjoyed making this super simple back quiver slash back sheath with me. Credit where credit's due, I did not design this or make the original. A friend of mine gave it to me, but he didn't mind, and it's definitely worth sharing, so I wanted to show you all how to make it. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you decide to make one of these for yourself. That's all I have for you today, guys. Archer out.